Hello, fellow adventurers! I'm Dreadwitch, and I wanted to talk about how I run hacks to be more like Baba Yaga from Slavic fairy tales. So first, let's talk about the witch herself. Baba Yaga is one of the most prolific hags in fairy tales, specifically mostly Russian fairy tales. She is described as being super tall, stretching out across her entire hut diagonally, and also she's described as being super ugly with warts and drooping boobs, and she's often also called bony legged. Sometimes that's a real bone leg, and sometimes that's just knobby knees, I guess. She rides in a mortar and pestle with a broom to sweep up her track. Her hut is always found in the land between life and death, and it has chicken legs and a bone fence that often has one skull missing for her next victim. Her catchphrase for whenever people come is "foo foo foo, I spell Russian blood," because she's a cannibal and likes to drink Russian blood, I guess. I guess it's specifically Russian as well. Even though she's a cannibal, she's often super helpful in a lot of the stories. Vladimir Prop has a fairy tale morphology, which defines what certain characters are, and she's usually either a benefactor or a villain, or both at the same time. She kind of falls outside of the lines of his morphology, which makes her much more mysterious and much cooler. So I've taken all of these things that I know about Baba Yaga from the fairy tales, and I've used them to make some more fun quest lines and ideas for how I want to personally run hags. Before even starting to run a hag, I have to know what my players' characters want. I need my players to have a goal, and possibly a goal that they're desperate for. So something like getting some sort of MacGuffin or whatever, you know, anything that I think the players are absolutely desperate for. That way I can bring in a hag and actually make some sort of fun quest line where she can be helpful to them. People don't go searching out a hag without wanting something, or they don't at least search out Baba Yaga without wanting something or needing something. So then I have the players set out to find the hag, and I definitely want to have one session where they're reaching the hag and they're traveling to find her, because I have cool concepts of little roleplay encounters for them to interact with along the way. The players have to find the proper path, but also they need to maybe have magic words to make her hut stop spinning, because that's a really common fairy tale trope within Russian fairy tales. The other thing that I include is that when the players near the hag's house, the animals and the trees and the objects like the gates or whatever start talking to you. And when they start to speak to you, I definitely think that sometimes they're asking for things, or, you know, making the players drain some resources so that when they reach the hag, they don't just have everything. In a lot of fairy tales, if you help some of the things around Baba Yaga's house, you have an easier escape route, which could also be a really fun thing. So, like, if the players just don't do anything, they just don't give anything, it becomes harder to run away later if they need to. But those are just some fun little roleplay events prior to meeting the hag. Once the players meet the hag, their expectations will generally come into play. D&D generally leans towards hags making deals where the characters have to give something up. Like, I think Matthew Mercer said your artistic talents or something. Or, you know, you have to give up some sort of character detail, or your hands, or, you know, your eyes, which I think that a lot of players try to weasel out of. Baba Yaga either just gives the hero whatever they want, or she gives them a quest or a task to do. And I think this would be a really good way to keep players on their toes, and also more likely to going and seeing a hag. If there are rumors that hags are just sometimes giving away items or advice or spells, you know, the players are way more likely to possibly try and see if the hag will just give them what they want. And sometimes I think that I would personally just give them whatever they want. Every once in a while. Not often. Beforehand, I'd have to think about what the hag specifically wants, and then I could decide whether or not I just outright give the players whatever they want. I know Volo's guide says that hags want to make everyone miserable, but I don't think that's exactly how I run hags. Baba Yaga doesn't really want to make everyone miserable. She has really mysterious goals, and it's uncertain whether or not she wants to make you miserable or if she wants to be helpful or anything. Okay, so I talked about just giving the players what they want. The other side of it is obviously giving them a quest. If I give my players a task, it's going to be an impossible task, or at least something that I consider impossible. My players know that if they complete this task, they will have no consequences, there will be nothing where she takes something from the characters. Most likely. Baba Yaga still sometimes goes back on her word, but I'd say 99% of the time she doesn't. So anyways, some of my ideas for impossible tasks can be things like making a level 3 party go kill an ancient dragon, or telling them to bring the head of the king, or things like that where it's something that I think would be absolutely impossible. Players almost always come up with ideas that I never thought of. Plus, they'll think about the wording of whatever you said and they'll figure something out. I think this sort of impossible task is also a great way to introduce a major villain, especially if you're running a longer campaign. The task from Baba Yaga could be to kill the major villain or even just steal something from the major villain. Then you get to introduce your major villain early, and that's always way more fun. Now, if the players fail the task, you kind of need failure states, and I have a few. I mean, you could easily fall back on the, oh, you have to take something from the character, like their eyes, or their hands, or the memory of their favorite family member, whatever. But generally, I just make the hag angry at the party. This generally means that the hag will attack the party. I don't personally use the monster manual stats for hags because I think they're a little bit weak, and I personally like Matt Caulfield's action-oriented monsters, so I generally fall back onto that. But if I run a stronger hag, I generally have a certain clause within the hag stats that says if she kills one of the party members, she will begin to eat that member, like full stop attacking people, and she'll just start munching and crunching. This gives the other players a chance to run, especially if they're really low and I don't do a TPK. I've done a TPK in the past, and man, getting out of that is hard work. If the players end up killing the hag, I don't usually have the hag actually die. In the stories, you can kill Baba Yaga, but you can't. She doesn't die. She's not really alive or dead in the same way. So she'll always come back for another story. Either I have the hag begin to stitch her body back together, just kind of grabbing pieces and slowly starting to sew them back together. I think it's a really creepy image to just see body parts moving and just stitching each other together, which is a slow process, so the party has time to get away. The other option I have is if you enter her hut again after you've killed her, you'll see that there's a hag again laying out stretched diagonally across the entire hut, and when you look up close, it's the same hag. And she'll say something along the lines of, "Oh, you've come back for more. Oh, how wonderful." Most of the time, if I were to introduce that to my party, they would just run. Whenever Baba Yaga comes back, I have her still be angry at the party. And this allows me to give my villains a lot of magic items because I just tell them, oh, Baba Yaga's been funding them and supplying them. It lets me make my villains even scarier and lets me use even more magic items, which is really fun. I think Baba Yaga's hut is full of really strong one-time use magic items. I think everything in Baba Yaga's hut should be super magical once you take it from her hut. These items would be one-time use, super powerful, and I definitely give my villains at least one or two of them. If my players talk to someone who knows about hags, I definitely tell them that they should steal from the hag's house if they can get away with it. Then I could possibly give my players some fun one-time use powerful items that are based from fairy tales, maybe a feather from a firebird or Koshchei's heart. I don't know, something fun that I could do flavor with the Russian fairy tales that I know about. But yeah, these are my ideas for hags. I just want them to be more like Baba Yaga and mysterious and sometimes a benefactor and sometimes a villain. Anyways, if you enjoyed my video, I'll probably be posting some more videos about D&D very soon. Also, if you want, you can follow me on Twitter and Twitch at Dreadwitch. I'm planning on streaming some D&D world building and setup stuff soon. So if you want to watch and maybe help give me some input, I love to hear and talk about Dungeons & Dragons all the time. I hope you have a good day. So take it easy.